In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned, in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us all our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Lord God, teach us at all times to love your holy name, for you never withdraw your guiding hand from those you establish in your love. We ask you this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God for ever and ever.
A reading from the prophet Jeremiah. Jeremiah said, I hear so many disparaging me, terror from every side, denouncing, let us denounce him. All those who used to be my friends watched for my downfall. Perhaps he will be seduced into error. Then we will master him and take our revenge. But the Lord is at my side, a mighty hero. My opponents will stumble, mastered, confounded by their failure. Everlasting, unforgettable disgrace will be theirs. But you, O Lord of hosts, you who probe with justice, who scrutinize the loins and heart, let me see the vengeance you will take on them, for I have committed my cause to you. Sing to the Lord, praise the Lord, for he has delivered the soul of the needy from the hands of evil men. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
In your great love, answer me, O Lord.
In your great love, answer me, O Lord.
It is for you that I suffer taunts, that shame covers my face, that I have become a stranger to my brothers, an alien to my mother's sons. I burn with zeal for your house, and taunts against you fall on me.
In your love, answer me, O Lord.
This is my prayer to you, my prayer for your favour. In your great love, answer me, O God, with your help that never fails. Lord, answer, for your love is kind. In your compassion, turn towards me.
In your love, answer me, O Lord.
The poor, when they see it, will be glad, and God-seeking hearts will revive. For the Lord listens to the needy, and does not spurn his servants in their chains. Let the heavens and the earth give him praise, the sea and all its living creatures.
In your love, answer me, O Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Sin entered the world through one man, and through sin, death. And thus death has spread through the whole human race, because everyone has sinned. Sin existed in the world long before the law was given. There was no law, and so no one could be accused of the sin of law-breaking. Yet death reigned over all from Adam to Moses, even though their sin, unlike that of Adam, was not a matter of breaking a law. Adam prefigured the one to come, but the gift itself considerably outweighed the fall. If it is certain that through one man's fall so many died, it is even more certain that divine grace coming through one man, Jesus Christ, came to so many as an abundant free gift. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia. The word was made flesh and lived among us. To all who did accept him, he gave power to become children of God. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus instructed the 12 as follows. Do not be afraid, for everything that is now covered will be uncovered, and everything now hidden will be made clear. What I say to you in the dark, tell in the daylight, and what you hear in whispers, proclaim from the housetops. Do not be afraid of those who kill the body but cannot kill the soul. Fear him rather who can destroy both body and soul in hell. Can you not buy two sparrows for a penny, and yet not one falls to the ground without your Father knowing? Why, every hair on your head has been counted. So there is no need to be afraid. You are worth more than hundreds of sparrows. And so if anyone declares himself for me in the presence of men, I will declare myself for him in the presence of my Father in heaven. But the one who disowns me in the presence of men, I will disown in the presence of my Father in heaven. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
May the words of the Gospel be with us. In this passage from Matthew's Gospel, Jesus tells his disciples no fewer than three times, each time more emphatically, do not be afraid. And that same injunction runs throughout the Gospels like an antiphon. Now, St. Thomas Aquinas, always keenly interested in and ever realistic and sympathetic about all human emotions, has a great deal to say about fear. But he says it in the context of what he has to say about the virtue which prevents us from being overpowered by fear, namely courage. He would have heartily agreed, for instance, with President Roosevelt's rousing sentiment, we have nothing but fear to fear, but fear itself. He, of course, was paraphrasing Montaigne. It's fear that I fear most, he says in his essay on fear. Aquinas remarks that someone who falls from a great height because they've lost their balance has probably been unbalanced not by the great height, but by fear of falling. Courage would have held his fear in check and saved him from falling. But notice he doesn't say that courage would have made him fearless, but that it would have prevented fear from overpowering him. Courage and fear, in other words, are not mutually exclusive. In fact, Aquinas thought that lack of fear in some situations is not only foolhardy, but dangerous. Fear is an essential tool in our innate and instinctive survival kit. And for that reason, St. Thomas is careful to distinguish between courage and reckless daring and rash behaviour. Rash behaviour induced by drunkenness, for instance, he says, has nothing whatever to do with courage. Drink induces false courage, he says, arising from an entirely false sense of your own capacities. But whereas false courage is rooted in an illusion, real courage, along with humility, enables us to keep our feet firmly on the ground. Of course, there's reckless daring and rash behaviour on the part of the stone-cold sober, too. People, for instance, who don't know their own limitations and weaknesses. It's an entirely uncomfortable truth, as well as a painful fact,
that we only learn our weaknesses by falling prey to them. But learn we must, because there is no more dangerous person than someone who doesn't know their limitations. And it's usually other people who fall prey to their limitations. Now in this gospel, even though Jesus is not only sending his disciples out penniless and destitute of material resources, but also ominously warning them that they will be as sheep among wolves, he nevertheless tells them that they're not to be afraid. He's not saying, however, that they won't, as a matter of fact, feel fear. He's telling them to get their fears not just under control, but in order. They're to fear untruth more than hostility, and the loss of their integrity more than the loss of life. But they're not to be just courageous, they're to be audacious too. And both their courage and their audacity are justified, he reminds them, because God is present not just within them, but in everything that happens around them. He reminds them, in other words, of God's providence, by telling them in one of the most picturesque of all his sayings that they are of infinitely more value than any number of sparrows. And yet, God doesn't fail to notice the falling to the ground of even one sparrow. Even the falling of one tiny, seemingly insignificant sparrow comes within God's providential purposes. And not even a single hair on their heads is outside of God's providence. God's providence, in other words, extends to and presides over even the smallest detail of our lives and every detail of life itself. It is all kept in existence by his providential will, so that nothing that has, can, or ever will happen is wasted or without meaning, even if, to us, for the time being, its meaning is impenetrable. And this applies equally, if not especially, even to our mistakes. Just as a virtuoso musician can creatively use his or her worst blunders and misreadings, so God can and does use creatively even our worst failings and fallings, incorporating all of them into the dance of his creation. But crucially, God's providence has nothing whatever to do with fatalism. Trusting in God's providence is precisely what makes every effort worthwhile, even if it constitutes the smallest of contributions. Trusting in God's providence enables us to plan wisely and boldly, and yet at the same time to sit lightly to all our plans. And it's precisely trusting in God's providence that keeps us open to change and enables us to respond positively and gratefully to its challenge. Only trust in God's providence enables us to take risks and blaze trails without fearing failure, rather than always playing for safety or approval. And only by placing our entire trust in God's providence can we live through the storms that can break over our comfortable worlds at any time, threatening our certitudes, undermining our confidence, overturning our lives even, as in the present pandemic, for instance. The virtue of courage would be an impossible and unattainable ideal if it were not rooted in our belief in God's providence. And of course, unsurprisingly, courage is a prerequisite if we're to sustain love throughout the whole of our lives, love both of one another and of God. It takes courage of a high order to make daring promises of loyalty and love, and even more to keep them. And according to Aquinas, at no time is courage more needed than when our time comes to embrace what St. Francis of Assisi called sister death. Aquinas thought that the perfection of courage consisted in accepting our own death. But unlike the pagan virtue of courage, which accepts death as the ultimate defeat, inevitable and unavoidable, the Christian virtue of courage accepts death as necessary. Far from being the end of hope, It is the first stage of its fulfillment, the final act of love and the fulfillment of faith, the last liberating letting go by which we fall into the embrace of the ineffable, merciful mystery we call God. But to use words attributed to St. Francis, it is in dying that we are born to eternal life. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us bring before God our Father all our needs.
That we may be filled with love and found without fault on the day of his coming, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
That we may be moved to help the homeless and the needy in our midst, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
That we may know the shortness of our lives and spend them for the glory of God and the good of our neighbours, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
That we may be granted the grace of detachment and the gift of true freedom, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
That the sick may know the comfort of Christ's presence, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
That this Eucharist may fill us with hope and courage, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
That those who have died may know the everlasting joy of God's kingdom, especially our relations and friends and all former members and benefactors of our college, in particular Tad Guzzi and Miles Fitzalan Howard, the 17th Duke of Norfolk. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Let us ask Mary, the Mother of God, to pray for us.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Let us pray in silence for all who have asked our prayers and for our own intentions.
Heavenly Father, hear all our prayers, spoken and unspoken, and grant all our needs, known and unknown. We ask you this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Lord God, we ask you to receive us and be pleased with the sacrifice we offer you with humble and contrite hearts. Lord, wash away my iniquity. Cleanse me from my sins. Let us pray that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands, the praise and glory of his name, and the good of all his holy church.
Receive, O Lord, the sacrifice of praise, and grant that cleansed by its action, we may make an offer our hearts pleasing to you. We ask you this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Saviour and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit, and born of the Virgin. Fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so, with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In the same way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Alan our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours, for ever and ever.
Amen.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory of yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. You who live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. May this mainly of the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring eternal life to us who receive it. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, by the will of the Father and the work of the Holy Spirit, your death brought life to the world. By your holy body and blood, free me from all my sins and from every evil. Keep me faithful to your teaching, and never let me depart from you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Renewed and nourished by the sacred body and the precious blood of your Son, we ask you of your mercy, O Lord, that what we celebrate with devotion may be our sure pledge of redemption. We ask you this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.